Okay. So now that you know how to create the form, and hopefully you created the form with me as we went through that last video, now I'm going to show you how to create the funnel, the pages that you're going to go ahead and send your people to. So let's go ahead and hop into my computer and let me show you how to build the funnel. Okay, so welcome inside my computer, and we're going to go to the same area, sites on the left-hand side, but this time we're going to go to funnels here at the top, and you'll see there's a bunch of funnels in here. We're going to go over to the right-hand side here where it says new funnel. We're going to go ahead and click that. We'll go ahead and name our funnel. We'll call this free weight loss funnel, or free weight loss ebook is probably better. Hit create funnel. And now you can see that we've created a funnel. Now, before we go and start building pages, let's quickly just take a look at what we've got here. So we have the ability to add as many steps to our funnel as we want, which we're going to add some steps in a second. We can see the stats of our funnel. So as time goes on, you can see how many people are actually making it through your funnel, what percentage are actually opting in and getting the information. And those economics, those numbers, because they turn into economics if you're running advertising, are important later on, and we'll discuss those in other videos. So all your stats are right here. That's the great thing about having things built out in a funnel versus on your website, is it makes it much easier to see the conversion rate of the funnel. You can still see it on the website. It's just harder to get the data. Now, the other thing you can see is sales. If you have any order forms built in here, maybe you're selling your ebook for a certain amount of money, you can see your sales. And then obviously you have your settings, okay, which we'll go through after. Now, let's go back to steps here. The first thing we're going to do is click add new step. We're going to give this a name. We're going to say free weight loss ebook opt-in. And then the path will just be, you know, weight loss ebook opt-in. So this will be whatever domain we're using, / weight loss ebook opt-in. We're going to go ahead and hit create step. And there's our page. Okay. Now, I'm going to go ahead and start from blank here, and I'm going to show you how to quickly and easily build out a page using the web page builder. So we're actually inside the web page builder right now. For the purposes of this video, not to make it super long, I'm going to show you the bare necessities of what you need to know, but certainly feel free to explore this as you go through it. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to come up here to the top. So we're going to grab full width. We're going to drag that out. Now we have a full width section right here. Now, typically, most people are going to hit add a row. They're going to add a one column row. And then you're going to add element, and you're going to choose image on the right hand side over here. All right, you'll probably put your logo in here. So I'm going to go ahead for this example, and I'm going to go ahead and upload file. Let's go find a logo that I may have been playing around with earlier. Here we go. Here's a Market Chief Messenger logo. And that's fine. So I'm going to hit back. And actually, I got to go back in there. So I'm going to click right here and I'm going to double click on that so it fills in. All right. Now that's huge. So you can see right here, it says width. I don't know, 250 is probably fine. Okay. So what do? We took out a section with a row with an element inside it, which is an image. So we have our branding at the top. Now, below here, we're going to go ahead and click on this little green plus sign. This time, we're going to click out a full width row just like that, or section rather, and then click add row, and we'll do a two column section this time. Okay. On this side right here, we want our form. So we're going to click add element. We're going to click on form, and then we're going to go here in the drop down, and we're going to choose the free weight loss ebook, right? That's the form that we just created in the last video. Over here on this left hand side, typically what you're going to do is probably put an image in here, show an image of your ebook. You know, there's graphic artists that can whip you up a nice cover that makes it look like a book. And it really, really will help enhance, you know, or increase the opt-in rate if you have an actual image. Even though they're getting an ebook, make it look like a real book. Okay. And we'll talk about that more later. So we'll have an image here. We have the opt-in here. Now, a couple of things. We're going to go ahead right here and we're going to add another row in here, and we're just going to do a single column. And then I'm going to push this up. See, if I hover over here, I can move that up with this arrow. Boom, right above there. Okay. Because I want to put in a headline, and then below it, I'm going to hit this orange arrow. I'm going to hit put in a sub headline. Okay. because I need a headline and a subheadline to get people to opt in for my thing. So at a bare minimum, this is what we need to get people to opt in. Now, typically we'll do one more section, or one more element rather. I'm gonna click on the orange. We'll do a subheadline. I'm gonna move it up, and then we're just gonna say enter your info to get free access. Okay. So something to the effect of kind of telling them what to do below here. Okay. Image here, headline, subhead. Very good. Now, can you add more things down below here? Of course you can. Should you keep your opt-in ebook pages simple? Yes, you really should. Okay. If you wanted to put one more section down here, and let's say a full width, we'll do a 2-column, and then you could do some bullet points, right? So you could go over here where it says bullet list, and then you could start putting in, you know, some cool bullets. You know, here's some more stuff, right? And just, you know, kind of tell them what they can expect to learn in your ebook, right? What kind of information are they going to get? So maybe a few of those. You can actually duplicate and then drag over, right? And so you have, you know, a couple bullet lists there with some goodies and reasons why they would want to go in there and get this ebook, okay? So I'm going to delete this. I'm going to go over here where it shows you the trash can. Click that and delete it. One more thing you could do, just to give you an idea here, is you could add another full width. You could do a row with 3 columns, and then you could actually put in a few testimonials of people who have read the book, who've gotten results from the book, who really enjoyed the book, and that could help you increase your conversion rate. Again, everything's about how many people came here, how many people actually gave you their email and opted in for the book. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and delete this. Again, you can add as much as you want. Simple usually works better. A quick little copy hack for you. I know this isn't a copy training, but I do wanna give you kind of an idea of what you could write here. Get this desired end result, okay? So this is kind of a formula, get this desired end result. So you'd fill in the blank there. So get this desired end result without, you know, dealing with this frustration. Okay. So something along the lines of, you know, discover this, get this result, get this benefit, get this thing without having to deal with this thing, right? It's a powerful headline formula. And typically it's straight to the point. What's one main thing this ebook is going to do for them if they opt in and get access to it and read it? And so you can use that headline formula. Over here on the left, we can change the desktop font size. So if you drag this over, you can kind of make things fit a little bit better. There you go. And then below here, you could write a subheadline that carries on a little bit more about what they're going to get when they actually get access to this ebook. Okay. So that's how you create your landing page. Now, in effect, right now, at this point, this is actually in here. If we go save and we go preview, here's your landing page, right? So you have your branding up here, you have your headline here, subhead, and then you've got your opt-in here, and you've got an image of your actual book on this side over here, okay? Perfect. Very, very simple. Easy. All right, so now let's go ahead and, you know, one thing you could do over here from a design perspective is you could make the background of this particular, you know, section here just to grab their attention. You'd obviously have to change the color. So if you click on your headline here, you have to change the color of that to white. But you can see that it does draw the eye over into that area a little bit easier. Okay. So that's it for this particular page right here. So we're going to go ahead and save this, and we're going to back out over here with this back button. If it's not saved, it will tell you it's not saved. And so we're going to go back here. Now, here's what you've got to decide. You've got to decide, do you want to drop them on the next page and give them direct access to your PDF, which I don't recommend, your ebook, right? Or do you want to drop them on a thank you page and let them know to go check their email for the link to the PDF? The reason why that's probably a better way to do it is because you don't want them giving you fake information and then just landing there and getting access to a PDF and you don't have any information, just a dummy email, okay? So a great way to do it is drive them to a thank you page, and even to the point of telling them on this page, you know, enter your information and we'll send the link over for you to access your PDF, right? So if I go, let's go edit this real quickly. So below this here, we could hit the plus sign, put a paragraph in there. Obviously, we need to change the color of our text to white. And then you'd say, enter your information to get free access. Email, and this is where you kind of let them know. Check your email or cell phone for the link to download, right? So now they're like, oh, okay, I have to actually give them a good email address because if I don't, I'm not going to be able to get this book, okay? So that's that. Let's back out of here, save that. And so now you've got your first page of the funnel built. Beautiful, right? The next page would be, let's go ahead and add a new step. We're going to go weight loss. Thank you. And then again, your path could be whatever. It's always going to have to be unique. We'll just go, thank you. That's pretty well. Perfect. And then hit create funnel step. Okay. Now we're going to go in here and edit this page. And again, all I'm going to do, you can tell, once you get the hang of this, it's very easy to go in here and build these pages out. I'm just going to go in once this loads and I'm going to add a section. I'm going to drag a full width section out. Again, if I want to drag out my header, I can, you know, put my logo in there. So I can go like this and just click in here, double click, change this width to 250. Perfect. And then I'm going to go ahead and add a new section. And I'm just going to put in here a column, an element, which is going to be a headline and say, you know, success, your request has been sent, right? Then we can go ahead and add a subhead below here and say, check your email or, you know, and or mobile phone for the download, you know, and I might even put a picture of my book here again. So I might throw an image below here just to really entice them, you know, with being able to see the book. And I'll go grab an example of a book cover and I'll put it in here just so you can see it. So let me pause this. Okay, so here's an example of a book image that we had made for a client. You can see how nice it pops right off the page, right? You know, and if we save this and we go back to the original page and put this image into our opt-in, you know, we're going to notice that it's just really going to start to pop. And I know we're using weight loss and we've got a stealth war book. We're just, you know, kind of just using that as an example, okay? So forgive me on that. Let's put that in there. Let's make this like 350, you know? And so there you go, right? You get this nice effect. You get this nice promise, what they're going to get. You show them a picture of it so it gets them excited, and then you give them a nice easy way to go ahead and give you their information to opt in and get the book, okay? So let's go ahead and exit out of there. Okay, so there's your two-step funnel. They come, they opt in. They come here, they land on the thank you page, and they're good to go, okay? Now, in another video in this training, I'm gonna show you how to connect your domain to MarketChief so you can easily come in here, connect the subdomain in here, and just go ahead and put your funnel live on your domain, all right? So we'll show you how to do that, super easy, but we'll show you that in another video. So there's your funnel. You can see it wasn't that hard to build out these opt-in funnels. Once you play around with this a little bit, you'll start to get the hang of it. And then one more thing I want to show you before I end this video is you can do a split test, right? So you can create a variation. You can actually, once you get it connected to a domain, create a variation for this. For example, maybe try a different headline. Maybe try a video here instead of an image of the of what they're getting. You know, change one thing and have it split test. Our system will automatically split test your two pages to find the one that has the highest conversion. Right? Amazing way to go. You obviously want to use split testing because if you don't, then you're not giving yourself the fairest chance at getting the highest conversion. So anyway, that's it for this video. I know it was long enough, probably the longest video of all the videos here, but that's how you build the funnel out. I will see you in the next video.